Hello friends, welcome back. Hearty welcome to you. Let us look at this interesting problem. We have to find out the least positive value of p such that sine of p cos x equal to cos of p sin x, where x is defined in the interval 0 to 2 pi. So x lies in the interval 0 to 2 pi. We have to find out the least positive value of p such that sine of p cos x equal to cos of p sin x. So first let's write down what we have been given. We have been given that sine of p cos x is equal to cos of p sin x. Now I have to find out the least positive value of p such that this equation is satisfied in the interval 0 to 2 pi. Now first what I will try to do, since I have sine and cos, let me try to convert them into either one of them. So I will write down sine of p cos x is equal to, can I write it as sine of pi by 2 minus p sin x, because we know cos theta equal to sine of pi by 2 minus theta. Now that means, now sine is applied on these two angles, that means the angles should be equal. So p cos x equal to pi by 2 minus p sin x. Now when I go to the next step, I will have p cos x plus p sin x equal to pi by 2. Can I write down that? P cos x plus p sin x is equal to pi by 2. Or can I say p is equal to pi by 2 divided by cos x plus sin x? Now we have to remember that we have to find out the least value of p. The least value of p will happen when this value will become maximum. That means I have to understand what is the maximum value of function cos x plus sin x. So for this problem we can solve it in two ways from now. First we will take what is the maximum value of cos x plus sin x. Is it like, we know that for a cos x plus b sin x plus c, the max and the minimum values are given by c plus or minus root of a square plus b square. Comparing with cos x plus sin x, comparing with cos x plus sin x, we have a equal to 1, b equal to 1 and c equal to 0. So the max value will be c 0 plus root of a square plus b square, that is 1 square plus 1 square, which is equal to root 2. So the maximum value of cos x plus sin x is root 2. That means the least value of p is equal to pi by 2 into root 2. So this is one way of doing it, because we know the maximum value from here is root 2. It should be pi by 2 into root 2. There is another way to do that. Let's have a look at that one also. Now the other way how we can solve this problem is, we know that we need the least positive value of p. If I want small value of p, then denominator should be maximum value. When the denominator is maximum, the whole value will become, numerator by denominator becomes minimum value. We know that. So what we will do now, try to convert cos x plus sin x into a cos function or a sine function, then I can say that cos and sine is always between minus 1 and 1, and the max value it can take is 1. So this is another way of solving the problem. What I can do now, I can write down cos x plus sin x as root 2 into cos x by root 2 plus sin x by root 2. So whenever we are want to convert them into a cos or sine function, always remember we need to search for an angle which will have same value for cos and sine. That will be obviously pi by 4. So can I write this as now root 2 into cos x cos pi by 4 plus sin x sin pi by 4? Is it nothing but root 2 into cos of x minus pi by 4? So cos x plus sin x can be written as root 2 into cos of x minus pi by 4. Then my next step will be, that means p equal to pi by 2 into root 2 into cos of x minus pi by 4. But we know cos values will be between minus 1 and 1, and the max value cos function can take is plus 1. So this will become now 2 root 2 into 1. This value, the max value, it can go, let me write it here, the max value this can go is 1. So then p will be equal to, that means p equal to pi by 2 root 2. So that's one interesting example shared by one of the students. So I just thought of sharing that with you. Please do let me know your feedback. Thanks for your time and support. Keep smiling and sharing. All the best.